I think, like everybody, I'm interested in stories about ghosts or extraterrestrials. Some people would say, well, don't explain that. Don't explain that. I want to believe that. People call me a debunker. They say I'm trying to disprove. I'm raining on their parade. And you know what? I don't apologize at all for trying to find the truth.
And Joe Nickel from the Committee for Skeptical Inquiry.
We've invited renowned skeptic Joe Nickel to meet Cora Lorenzo.
This medieval superstition has got to go.
And this is really just silly, except...
I'm Joe Nickel, and I'm a paranormal investigator. I investigate everything from monsters, ghosts, aliens, psychics, for a science organization and the magazine Skeptical Inquirer. I knew at the age of 8 that I was a detective, but I eventually became a stage magician. Oh my goodness. My models were Harry Houdini and other magicians who used their magic talents to expose trickery. And meanwhile, like everybody, I was curious about haunted houses and flying saucers, and I decided I wanted to do something like that. I've written about 40 books, primarily on mysteries. A lot of cases were miracle claims or some kind of religious claims, spontaneous human combustion, lake monster mysteries, crop circles, UFO sighting, chupacabras, ghosts, Bigfoot. What I'm trying to do is actually investigate, looking for facts and clues. As you begin to put together a case file, you fill the file folder with what data you have, and then trying to find actually corroborative evidence so that I can try to explain what's happening, explain a UFO sighting. My explanations are often quite mundane. People report seeing these long-necked, multi-humped lake monsters. There are many things that can create the illusion of a lake monster, including 2 or 3 or 4 otters swimming in a line, which create the effect of one large creature. Bigfoot is a tall, hairy, bipedal creature. There is a creature that looks very much like Bigfoot, that is a black bear or a brown bear, standing, sniffing the air and walking about. People driving by an old mansion in the little community of Burt, New York, sometimes reported seeing a ghostly figure dressed in white. As it turns out, they had a mannequin dressed in white in the window, and that was responsible for many of those sightings. I think part of me would like for there to be ghosts and for there to be extraterrestrials. But I've done this a long time, and I'm pretty sure that ghosts don't exist. Even the skeptics who like what I do, well, often their first reaction is, that's pretty obvious. Everything is obvious after it's been explained.